Hi everyone, Mr. H here. In this video, I'm gonna help you review for your first semester final review. Okay, so this final review has 25 questions and is combination of three unit tests that we took in the past and a couple lessons that we learned in a few weeks ago. Okay, so we're gonna review on this one. Make sure you take a good note. You also have an extra credit option. I want you to do your semester final review on Alex, the practice one. Okay. If you earn 10%, for every 10% you earn on top of 50% on the practice test, you earn one extra credit on your final. What do I mean by that? If you score 60% on your practice test, you will earn one extra credit. If you score past 70, you will earn two extra credit. If you score past 80%, you earn three extra credit, and so on and so forth. If you score 100%, you earn five extra credit. Those extra credit will help someone like at 85, at 5, you get 90, so you go up to an A, right? So those five extra points, if you actually work on it, it's help a lot with the letter grade. All right, so we're going to look at problem number one, subtraction. This is so easy. So 34 minus 43. So basically, we can take 43 minus 34, right? So 3 cannot take away 4. Borrow 1 from the 4. That will give you 3. This is 13. 13 minus 4, that gives you 9. 3 minus 3 is 0. So the answer is 9. But since the 43 is a bigger number and it's negative, so remaining gonna be negative 9. All right, this one, negative times negative is positive, right? So negative 9 plus 6, opposite sign we subtract, so 9 minus 6 is 3, and same thing, 9 is a bigger number and it's negative, so the answer is negative 3. All right, that's it for number one. You can also use the calculator. So you can use calculator to check your answer if you wish to. Okay, number two. Number two, so same idea, positive times negative is a negative, right? So 45 minus 53. 53 minus 45. Same thing, 3 cannot minus 5. We borrow 1 from the 5. This is 4. This is 13. 13 minus 5 is 8. 4 minus 4 is 0. So the answer is 8. But since 53 negative, 53 is the bigger number, the answer is negative 8. All right, next one. We have positive times negative is negative. So negative 53 minus 25. Same signs we add. So that will be 53 plus 25. That would be 8, 78. And since they're both negative, you add them up. That's going to be negative 78. One more time, you can use calculator to check your answer. Make sure it's right. This is easy points here. All right, subtract fraction. Okay, to subtract fraction, you need the same denominator. We need to find the LCD. Okay, Alright. You need to find the LCD, 11 over 12 minus 7 over 8. So LCD is 24. It's the least common denominator. So 12 to get 24, you multiply by 2 on top and bottom. Okay, that will give you 22 over 24. On the second fraction, to get 24, you multiply 8 by 3. Okay, so that will give you negative 21 over 24. 22 over 24 minus 21 over 24, that will give you 1 over 24. And this is the lowest term, that's it. If you can reduce a fraction, you have to go further. Now, extra explanation, just in case some of you don't know, how do I come up with 24? So least common denominator is basically you compare two denominators. You compare your 12 Okay, the common, the multiple of 12, which means 12, 24, 36, the multiple of 12, 48. And then you compare the number 8. 8, you have 8, 16, 24, 32. And the next one is what? Times 5, 40. And then the next one is 48. Okay, so least common denominator. As you see that there's a common number is 24 and 48, right? But the least common denominator is the smallest number that both denominator have in common, which is 24. That's why the least common denominator is 24. If you understand this part, you can go ahead and skip that. All right, we go into the next one. If you think I explained too fast, guys, pause the video, listen to it again, or you can write it down and think about it. Okay? So when you study, you have a plenty of time to do this. Your final won't happen until Tuesday for period one and Wednesday for period two and six. All right, number four. Divide. All right, divide. How do you divide fraction? First of all, how do you divide fraction? Second, how do you write a mixed number in improper fraction? Okay, so basically, you multiply the bottom and add the top. Okay, multiply the bottom and add the top. 7 times 6 is 42 plus 3 is 45 over 7. Okay, the mixed number is 6 whole, which means you have 6, 7 over 7. Therefore, 7 times 6 is 42 plus 3 is 45 divided by 5. Okay, so to divide a fraction to a whole number, first you're going to put the whole number in a fraction form, which is 1. Okay, then we're gonna do is keep change flip. Keep change and flip. You keep the first fraction, 45 over 7. You change the division to multiplication. And you flip the last fraction. You flip it. Okay, that will be 1 over 5. Then we can multiply straight across, or you can reduce. It depends on whichever method you want to use. To make it clear, I will multiply straight across and reduce after. Okay, 45 over 35. Then, since they both end up with the 5, I can reduce it by 5, top and bottom. So 45 divided by 5 is 9, and 35 divided by 5 is 7. So the answer is 9 over 7. But I believe, seeing the problem give it to you in a mixed number, that's a mixed number here, they may want the answer in mixed number as well. So this will be 1 whole and 2 over 7. You can make one group of 7 out of 9, so that's why it's 1 whole. And remaining over, after you take 7 out to make one group, remaining is 2, so that's why you have 2 over 7. All right, problem number 5. All right, same idea. You're going to multiply a whole number to a fraction. So first, you need to write this in a improper fraction. What do we have to do? Multiply the bottom and add the top. Okay, 9 times 4 is 36. Plus 2 is 38 over 9. And then bring down the 6 times 9, 38 over 9. Same idea like division. This is 6 over 1. The difference is you multiply, then we multiply straight across. Keep change and flip only used for division, not for multiplication. Multiplication, you multiply straight across. 6 times 8 is 48. Remember 4. 6 times 3 is 18 plus what did I say? 48, 18 plus 48 is 228 over 9. All right. And C, can we reduce this? I'm thinking we can reduce it by 3, right? If I reduce it by 3, 22 divided by 3 is 7. Remember 1, 18, 76. And this divided by 3 gives you 3. 76 can also divide by 3, right? Is it? 7, 18, 76. This feels like it can, but it cannot. Because 76, if you still remember the trick that I taught you before, that if you add two digits, 7 plus 6 is 13. 13 cannot divide by 3, then it's not divisible by 3. So now we have to write a mixed number because the problem gave it to you as a mixed number. So your answer have to be a mixed number. So 76 divided by 3. 3 going to 7 twice. Okay, 2 times 3 is 6. Draw the line, change the sign. 7 minus 6 is 1. Bring down the 16. 3 going to 16 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15. Draw the line, change the sign. Remainder is 1. So 76 divided by 3 is 25 whole and 1 remainder out of 3. And that's it. All right. Next one. What do you do? Click this and to move to the next one. All right, so this is number 6. We're gonna go to the next video for number 6.